Hello and welcome. This is Revenues, Expenses, Dividends, and Basic Financial Statement Creation, Part 1. Bennett Tchaikovsky, CPA, ESQ. Disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2019 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. I encourage you to share this presentation and share links to this presentation on an unmodified basis. If you modify the presentation in any way, please email me prior to doing so at bennett1812@gmail.com to discuss. I do not claim any copyright whatsoever in any of the companies or organizations mentioned in this presentation. Rather, the other parties are the owners of their respective copyrights. So up until now, we've been focusing on the December 31st accounting party, and I really want to recommend that you watch those videos prior to coming here, because if you don't know how to go through and use T accounts to record transactions that are involving assets, liability, and equity accounts, this is going to be a disaster. So, what are we doing now? Well, we had the December 31st accounting party, and the reason why I did that was so that we can use that one day as a learning period. And part of the other reason why I did that is that if we go beyond a day, then what we have is we have this particular issue about, well, what happens on a daily basis with the organization. So that's where we're now going to shift to. And as we know, businesses do operate year-round. And during that period of time, they will sell products or provide services, which is what we call revenues, and then they're going to incur expenses in the production of their revenues. And what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be looking about how to record revenues and expenses and then create an income statement. What exactly is an income statement? What the income statement does is it reflects a company's activities over a period of time. This is a very simplified one. You have the company name, income statement for the year or the period ending blank. And notice that this is different than the balance sheet. The balance sheet was a snapshot in time. The balance sheet is telling us on a particular day, what is our cash, what is our equipment, what are our asset, liability, and equity balances. When we're dealing with the income statement or revenues and expenses, we're dealing with a period of time from January 1st through December 31st. How much did we generate in terms of total revenues? What did those revenues cost us in terms of expenses? And then how much did we end up making or losing? So there's a big difference when we're labeling these financial statements. So right here, I'm going to have revenues are my total revenues, expenses are my total expenses. I subtract my expenses from my revenues, and I will either get a net income or a net loss. And what I wanted to do right now is to share with you some examples of publicly traded companies. And let's take a look at Facebook. Now, if you're wondering how I got here, please go and watch my earlier video where I describe how to look up companies and the SEC filing financial statements. But Facebook just recently issued their revenue or their financial statements hot off the presses. So right here, we've got revenue here from $55 billion for the 12 months ended December 31st, 2018. Here were their costs of revenue. They have costs of revenues, research and development, marketing and sales. So here is their revenue less their expenses is going to ultimately be giving them net income. And I don't want to overwhelm you with this part, but I do want you to kind of see is like, okay, revenue, my total expenses were $30 billion. So my income from my operations is this $55 billion minus the $30 billion or this $24 billion, which is really what we're doing, because when we're starting financial statements, I want you to learn just kind of take it easy at first, and then we'll expand on to this later. Then over here for eBay, eBay over here, they show things a little bit differently. they have their revenues and they have something here called gross profit, or this is just how they're going through and breaking it down, or their cost of revenues, and then they have their operating expenses here. So again, different companies have different forms in terms of their revenue statements. Not all financial statements are alike. That's what's very important to go through and remember. And again, so that's really, when we're looking at an income statement, it's really our revenues or what we generated less our expenses. Now let's look into define exactly what are revenues. So what are revenues? They're sales or the other earnings from a business. Okay, I can have a service business where I'm providing services. I might be providing tax services, legal services. I can also be selling items as a wholesaler, retailer, or manufacturer. Now, what's really important is that for these earlier chapters, we're only going to be dealing with services businesses, and there's a reason for that. Is because when we sell things, we have to do something special with the inventory. So we're not going to do that until we start talking about inventory transactions. So when we have revenue, what exactly is revenue? Technically, revenue is recognized now using five different steps. But that can kind of be, I don't want to overwhelm you with those five steps. You can look them up. But the way I want you to think about it is that as a company, we've either performed services or delivered goods. We're either entitled to payment or we receive payment, and we have no further obligations to our customer. Okay, so we've done everything we need to do in order to recognize that revenue. It's a sale. What is very important is that it does not matter if I have received the cash or not. The biggest driver is that if I've done the work, and am I entitled essentially to payment? The other thing about revenues is that revenues are considered to be temporary accounts. What does that mean? It shows what I've generated over a period of time. What ends up happening is at the end of the period, revenue is going to be closed out to retained earnings at that very, very end of the period. So, and then the other thing I want to mention to you right now is the way I always try to trick my students is the difference between unearned revenue and revenue. What unearned revenue is if I've received money from my customer and I have not yet performed the services, that is a liability. Why? Because I still have an obligation to the customer to deliver those goods or services. Therefore, it is not revenue, rather it is a liability. Revenue is I've gone through and I have essentially completed this process right over here. And wow, okay, here we go. Go back to presenting, and there we go. Okay, so those are revenues, okay? And what exactly are expenses? So expenses are the costs associated with the revenues that are being generated. We're going to try to match our expenses against our revenues wherever possible. Expenses are not assets. Rather, these are costs that we're basically using in our operations. Utilities expense. If I am operating a casino and that's my business and I have to pay a $70,000 electricity bill for the month, that's an expense of running my casino. I'm debiting utilities expense, I'm crediting cash. If I'm paying a consultant for them to provide services for me, that's also an expense. Salaries expense, rent expense, I'm using space. Insurance expense, I have the benefit of an insurance policy. Cost of the inventory. And again, similar to revenues in financial accounting, it doesn't matter whether or not the cash has actually been paid for the expense. If we have received the benefit of that expense, we need to record the expense. So just to kind of revisit our Tchaikovsky's T-theory of accounting, and this is kind of going back to what we were looking at before. We had assets equals our liabilities plus our owner's equity. What does this tell us? Assets are being recorded with debits. They're being increased with debits, decreased with credits. Liabilities and owner's equity typically have credit balances. They are increased with credits, decreased with debits. And now we're going to overlay this. And the way I like to think of this is that this is our nation's capital is Washington, D.C. And here we have the farmer who had a T-A-E-L-O-E. But here we've got expenses and revenues, or E-R. Where do we not want to end up on the weekends? The emergency room, okay? E-R. TV series with George Clooney, no one's going to get that. But right here, again, it's E-R. What does that mean? I typically go through and record my expenses with debits. Okay, so right under here. And I'm typically going to be recording my revenues with credits or over on this side. And let's see how this kind of works. So on March 31st, 2019, a company performs $200,000 worth of services for a client. And the client pays the company $200,000 on that date. And I want to apologize for using examples in fantasy land, just because I want to keep things simple. And then as we go forward and we do more examples, we'll be able to get a better sense in terms of how this works. But right now I'm more concerned with you understanding about how to record revenues. So the company has no further obligations to the client once a service has been performed. And we're going to record the transaction using T accounts. So I've performed $200,000 worth of services, and I got paid $200,000. So according to my T theory of accounting, I'm getting cash, so my cash is increasing, right? So I'm going to show that as a debit to cash right over here. At the same time, I'm getting this cash for every debit I need a credit, is that I've earned revenue. I performed the services. And so over here, I'm going to credit services revenue or revenue for $200,000. Now, even my students who are taking me for the second semester, when I'm having them analyze financial statements, are always going to concern, like, what's the difference between sales, revenue, it's all the same thing. It's a revenue account. They just call it different things. So if you kind of focus on the fact that, well, revenues, I'm going to record a revenue with a credit, that's how this is going to work. Okay, with expenses, on June 15th, 2019, a company receives consulting services from a vendor. The company receives an invoice from the vendor for 50 grand on June 15th, 2019, and immediately pays the vendor for the services. The vendor has no further obligations to the company once the services have been performed, record the transaction using T accounts. So this is the exact opposite. The vendor has given me services and I pay the vendor. So if I'm paying the vendor, right, I'm decreasing my cash and I'm going to do so here by around 50 grand. At the same time, they gave me consulting services. This is not an asset. They provided a service to me in the production of my income. So right here, I'm not getting equipment. They perform services for me. So right here, I'm going to be debiting consulting services expense, E-R-D-C, right? So I'm going to record the expense with the debit. Generally, if you can figure out what's going on with cash, this side over here will come pretty easy. It's just a matter of practicing. One of the things I want to go back here really quickly is I oftentimes get questions from my students about, dude, like, what's an invoice? Okay. So what an invoice is a written document where once a service provider or a seller of goods has completed the services or delivered products or services, I give them an invoice reflecting the services received. Now, to see this as an example, of course, where do I go? I'm going straight to Google. And I first went to Google, and on Google, what I found was like, oh, you got to sign up for Pinterest or whatever to see this. So this is something right here where, of course, I pulled this off of Google Sheets, which is like the most amazing program of all time. So the invoice typically looks like this. The company, that name that's basically providing the services, the invoice, who are you giving the invoice to? You're describing what you're providing to them. It could be invoice, basically goods or services. You're giving them a total. And then over here, you've got this. So this is what an invoice is. It's a document that is showing services that we've gone through and performed. Now, there's a lot of other terminology that is associated with an invoice, but we're going to go over that a little bit later. But I want you to understand that when I say invoice, I received an invoice, that means someone performed services for me. If I'm issuing an invoice, if I invoice someone, that means I've done the services and I'm telling the client, pay me. So this is going back over here to the terminology. So that's what an invoice is. The customer or the client is the party who is going to be receiving the goods or the services. What is a retailer? Now, for retailer, wholesaler, and manufacturer, we're going to really look at this a little bit later when we get to inventory, but the retailer is someone who's purchasing the goods wholesale or direct from the manufacturer and then resells the goods to the public. 99-cent store, Dollar General, they get people that come in, they say, hey, Dollar Store, you can buy this for 35 cents and then resell it for 99 cents. A wholesaler is someone who's purchasing goods from a manufacturer and then selling to a retailer. A manufacturer is the company who's creating the original product and then selling it to a retailer or manufacturer. With Costco, we're kind of getting into a weird kind of blend because Costco is a retailer, but at the same time, they're also a manufacturer with their Kirkland products and they're also a retailer. A service provider is the party who is providing services to a client. And then a vendor is a party who is providing goods or services to a company. I want to encourage you that if you come across terminology that you haven't seen, what do? Go on Google, look it up, do a search, figure out what that is. So it's really important that as you're going out there and developing your business vocabulary, that if you don't know something, you go through and look it up. So that brings us to the end of today. So again, we're just kind of learning how to go through and record expenses and revenues. And again, revenues, doesn't matter if I've received the cash, rather am I entitled, have I done what I'm supposed to do, have I completed my performance obligations, and am I entitled to payment? The cash receipt does not matter. If I've earned it, then it's good. And note here, today, if I was teaching you intermediate accounting, we would be going through five steps, but this is not intermediate accounting. What are expenses? Those are those costs that are associated with those revenues that are being generated. We try to match the expenses against revenue wherever possible. This is something called the matching principle. Very important though is that expenses are not assets. We're using them to be generating that revenue. And again, the cash payment for expenses doesn't matter. And we remember, what's our equation here? It's ER, right? Expenses, revenue. Our nation's capital, where it may be shut down at any moment, is Washington, D.C. I record expenses with debits. I record revenues with credits. Okay, and that brings us to the end of the day today. I want to thank you for joining me, and I will see you on the next video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Thank you.